There are times you want to edit your photos on the go. Snapseed is my favorite, and I've got a couple of secret tips for you. Please don't spend any time when you're out in a beautiful location like this editing your photos, but when you're back in the car or the hotel or home, yeah, I think it's fine to edit these days. And while you can get RAWs into Snapseed, especially on iOS, I think a quick edit of a JPEG is fine, whether it's going to go on Instagram, Facebook, or in your Instagram stories. Snapseed can edit RAW images. On iOS, you can get a variety of RAW formats in there from Canon, Nikon, Sony, Fuji, pretty much all of your current manufacturers, easily into Snapseed. On Android, it really only supports the DNG RAW, either created by your phone if it shoots RAW, or those few cameras that do, or you can convert, but it really is more hassle than it's worth. I'm going to show you real quick when you edit a RAW photo from wherever you come into a development panel that's different than the other tools. Similar, but different. So generally in Snapseed, you work through the settings by scrolling your finger up and down. You change the values of those settings by scrolling left or right. It's not the most intuitive interface at the beginning, but it works quite well. So you can work all the way through and make changes. The biggest benefit of shooting RAW, even on these smaller sensors, is that ability to really change your white balance, which is your temperature and your tint. You actually even have a little white balance slider down here at the bottom where you can make those changes. When you're happy with your RAW edits, you hit the check mark, and now you're into the normal Snapseed interface. The RAW development panel sits up above, but you have all of the rest of these tools that allow you to make these basic edits. And at any time that you want, you can go back into the development panel and make adjustments. The healing brush tool is really powerful. I need to take out a few of these branches. Here it is on the right-hand side, the little cross band-aid, healing. The tip or technique for using this is to pinch and zoom in so you see just what you need to remove. And it works very similar to content-aware fill in Photoshop. Sometimes it seems to work even better. Now that was a pretty easy test of this tool. Let's go look at using a harder one. And I'm gonna go straight to the healing brush tool because I wanna take out that dark branch in the background. I really loved this moss and the little details of the water drops on it, but I could not come up with a good framing that captured that without getting that branch back there as well. So I wanna try to take it out. So I'm gonna zoom in, pinch to zoom. And I'm going to just start to draw little bits at a time. And you can see that it didn't do a great job there. I could either back up and try a smaller amount, or I could just try again. Just keep going over the same area and have it sample newly again. And I'm just going to drag the navigator down to work through this section. Now it looks like I need to make a call. It runs into that droplet back there. That droplet is already a little bit out of focus. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and say, get rid of it. And I really, the one thing you wanna watch out for, let's zoom in even a little bit more, is duplications of stuff that's very noticeable. So this kind of soft blur background, it's very easy to hide duplications in there. Double tap brings it back out, and I think it did a great job. So that was little bits at a time. Zoom way in to get just what you need and try again, or back up and try again. Now I'm going to run through my raw edits of this real quick and go back to the development. The branch is back, but that's only because when you're working on the raw, you're working on the original. When I move back out of here in a minute, it will jump me back forward to those edits I've made, plus add in the raw edits. Structure really brings out the detail. Saturation obviously increases those colors, but you want to be very careful not to use it too much. Now I want to further emphasize the details in the water droplets and the moss right there. Snapseed provides a brush tool that gives you the ability to change. You can dodge and burn, you can change exposure, temperature, and saturation. However, it does not give you selective control over something like clarity or sharpening, but there's a way to do it. So I'm going to come into the tools panel again, go to details, which gives me structure. You can see it really starts to pop there in the lower part. And sharpening. So I'm going to bring my structure up, way more than I would normally. And I'm going to bring my sharpening up a good bit more too. I don't like what it's done in the background, but we're going to fix that in just a second. So I've accepted those changes, and you can see that it looks great here, way too sharp in the background where it's already out of focus. And come to the little history panel where I can undo or I can view all of my edits. If I click view edits, here's a little list of everything I've done. It's the history. I can click on the details again, and this little slide out will allow me to get back in and make adjustments to it. I don't want to do that. Or right in the middle, the brush. This allows you to selectively apply or remove anything that you've done in Snapseed. So right now, if I paint with a brush, you can see that red shows where I painted. I'm painting with 100% of that effect. In this case, it's the details. So I can continue to kind of come up, and I'm going to pinch to zoom in again, and I'm just going to paint that 100 details on those water droplets in the foreground. And I'm not painting it on the background at all. And let's take it a step further and say, yes, we like that. We're going to come back in. We're going to do another details. This time we're going to take the structure way down and the sharpening way down, really soften that background, hit the check mark. So that's been applied everywhere now. Go back into the view edits, go into that second one that is the decrease of everything, and apply that up there, softer, and decrease it a little bit in this area to kind of help that transition. We do our red to see the mask. You can see that we've kind of blurred it a little bit. Maybe I should have done that a little bit more. And let's do that. So now we've really separated that foreground and that background with a little bit of editing, and we did it by editing. Let me show you one more just to make sure we've nailed this home. Let's do something ridiculous. We can come in here and you could even do lens blur, but let's go to black and white and accept that. Let's change all of this black and white. Now, I never recommend you do this, but this is an excellent example of what you can do with this brush control. So I'm going to go into view edits. Here's my list, including the black and white. I go into the brush edit and it's suddenly turned back to color. I have to paint that effect on it now. So you can see that if I wanted to, I could leave that little strip of green that's terrible. Selective coloring, it's not even an example of selective coloring, but it's terrible. But it shows you exactly what you can do in control with Snapseed.
That's it. Just a couple of quick tips to make your editing better. I'd love to know in the comments, do you prefer Snapseed over Lightroom or vice versa? And share your favorite mobile editing tip. Thanks so much for watching, and if you found this useful, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you. I'm so in love with you. You got me down again.